got a brand new tool, and we're gonna try it out too. So this is how we, I believe. Don't lose your washers. Don't lose your washers. Put your washers on both of the side screws. Those should definitely sit here, if I'm not mistaken. I might have to move this around. Is where this will sit. And you'll have screw with the ball on the tip of it. And then that should sit dead center. You might have to adjust this screw actually. So the center screw you're gonna have to adjust. Right size. So we're gonna mess with that and we'll be back. So you have these two bolts right here on the side. These are 13s. Make sure you snug those down. They ain't gotta be super tight. This one should be, I'm gonna say a 17. Right on point. I'll show you guys something afterwards. When you get them, sometimes these bars may be flipped right side up, but you'll be able to push down in here. See that? You should be able to get the retaining clips out of there at some point, but you maybe want to use a ratchet. You don't really want to use an impact. It was pushing, that's the intake side, so it was pushing the intake valve down into the table. But you know, this head is already gone, so it doesn't even matter. So now we can see our retaining clips. You can get a little magnet or whatnot. Your little magnet and you can get your retaining clips. Let's get a little bit closer view. That's one. Maybe go to the other side maybe. This is the other. Some down on the table. Then you take your gun or your wrench, should be a wrench, and just come back up off of it real nice. Damn. There you go. Okay, so now you have your spring. Cap seal is down there. We got the washers down below, and you could just replace it that way. But a little tool is nice and handy.